Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video, we are talking about expensive products that suck. That really, really suck. I've done another one of these videos back when I started my channel, so be sure to watch that one. I will link it down below. But yeah, I see all YouTubers make disclaimers before they do one of these shitty product videos. I'm going to do that too because I don't want people to get mad at me in the comments. I don't like that. So, even though I don't like these products and you do, that's fine. We all have different preferences, different skin types. I may hate it. You may love it. It's all good. It's just makeup. Also, I love each and every brand I'm going to talk about. Just these products are not good. So if you guys want to see which expensive products are not worth your money, then please keep on watching. So I'm going to try to give you guys alternatives, just so this whole video isn't completely negative. So the first thing we have here is the Hourglass number 28 Primer Serum. And you guys, this is $80, first of all, $80 Canadian, so it's expensive. It's very expensive. But this thing is thick. Like, when I say thick, it is thick. So unless you have, like, Sahara Desert dry skin, you cannot pull this off. Like, I have dry skin. And my makeup is off my face within a couple of hours when I use this. It is just so thick and goopy. It feels like a really heavy serum, like one you would want to use at nighttime. Not something you would want to use under your makeup. Your makeup is just going to slip and slide all day. Also, it's not very good for sensitive skin because it does have a lot of irritating fragrant oils in it. So this guy is just, he's a no. But if you are wanting to splurge on a good primer and you're looking into Hourglass, the Veil Mineral Primer is really, really good. Now this actually does what a primer is supposed to. So it smooths the skin, it helps shrink your pores, it helps with fine lines, it perfects your face throughout the day, and it really makes your makeup stay put. So if you really want a good primer from Hourglass, go with this and avoid this. Okay, so the next product we have here is the Laura Mercier Candle Glow Concealer and Highlighting Pen. This guy is $38, and what really pisses me off about this is the color range. I think they have 6 or 7 colors in the range, and I am the second lightest. You guys, I am number one. There is only one shade lighter than me, which is 0.5. How am I, a brown girl, the second lightest shade? I mean, it is ridiculous. And the shade isn't even that light, you guys. Like, this is still a little bit dark for me. I mean, it's just unacceptable at this point in time. Like, having 7 colors, nothing too dark, like nothing on the dark side, nothing on the very light, is just unacceptable. Also, I don't really notice any light reflecting properties in it. I would use it like just as a normal concealer, whereas the YSL Touche Éclat, you could use it on like the high points of your face to really reflect light. This, it's like putting a legit concealer on the high points of your face. It just doesn't make any sense. So I don't like this. Also, I did try this out in a video and it completely cracked under my eyes and I had to go in with a whole different concealer, which is just a mess. If you are looking for a really good highlighting light reflecting pen, the MAC Prep and Prime pens are amazing. I have the color Light Boost, but there are a bunch of colors, I believe. Also, If you don't have too much discoloration, you could use this as a concealer. I can't use it as a concealer because I have shit to cover, but I do use it on top of my concealer and on the high points of my face to highlight, and it works beautifully. Okay, you guys, so this next product is just, it's just a mess. It's just a mess. This is the Dior Air Flash Matte Touch Long Lasting Airy Powder. This is something you're supposed to use as a last step to kind of set your makeup. First of all, this color is supposed to be universal, which is so ridiculous to me because it is legit orange. Like, it's orange, you guys. So if you're lighter than me, you can't use it. If you're darker than me, you can't use it. If you're like me, you can't use it because it is orange, it is a not universal, and it does not adjust like they say it does. You stay orange. Trust me, this has happened. And now I'm gonna zoom you guys in so you could see the catastrophe that is this product. Okay, you guys, so let me show you what happens when you spray this thing. Oh my God, it stings! Holy, I'm not even exaggerating, it's stinging my skin. That's not a good sign. But, oh, anyways, like this is what it looks like. Look at what happens when you try to blend this shit out. Do you see how it's falling? Like, imagine you do beautiful makeup and then you're like, I'm not gonna use the setting powder today. I'm gonna use the Dior Air Flash. And then you spray it all over your face. And then this happens. It's not fun, you guys. It's not fun. You guys, this is so crazy, but the area where I sprayed this, like, look at it on my hand. It's completely like red in that area. Like, I don't know what the hell is in this thing, but that didn't happen to my face when I used this. But then again, I haven't used it many times just because of what a mess it is. Okay, so next up, we have something luxury. We have a Burberry product. This is the Lip and Cheek Bloom. This guy is $33. Look at that packaging. Like, they have it down when it comes to packaging. The only thing is, the formula of this is very weird. It's very powdery. Like, you know when there's like a thick setting powder, a translucent or a loose setting powder, and when you put it through your fingers, that feeling, that's what this feels like. It feels like a moussey, moussey, powdery consistency. So when you go to blend it out, it because it's that consistency, it's very, very patchy. It skips and it balls up because it's almost like, it feels like a powder, and it just balls up on your skin and it doesn't look nice. Also, because it is that powdery consistency, it's very uncomfortable on the lips, and it literally accentuates every line and every dry patch. It's not a good product. If you are looking for a multi-use product that you can use on your eyes, lips, cheeks, the Bite Beauty Multi-Sticks are the way to go. These are amazing. They're so easy to use. You literally dry it on, blend it out with your finger, put it on your lips, and they work beautifully, and they have a really, really good shade range. So save your money. Go for this, not for this. Okay, so the next product isn't necessarily a bad product. I just think it's not worth the money. And that is the Burberry Highlighting Pen. This guy is $42, and I just don't think it's worth it. So it's one of these. I use this in my review of Burberry products. I'll link that video down below, but it's just like a stick highlight, and it's just too subtle. So you draw it on, but when you go to blend it out, there's almost nothing there. It's just too subtle. It's not worth the $42, in my opinion. If you wanna go for a cream highlight that really packs a punch, or you can make it very subtle, a really good one is the Milk Makeup Cream Highlight in Lit. I'm gonna show you guys a comparison. So there is lit. I'm gonna blend it out. See, when you blend it out, it doesn't lose its pigment. While the Burberry one, you could see in comparison, it's just shit compared to this one. So again, save some money and go with Milk Makeup. Nude Sticks makes a really, really good cream highlight. Clinique makes a really good one. Literally, you could find one in any brand now that's a shitload cheaper than that one. Okay, so this next product is just confusing, and I wanted to zoom you guys in so you can see the catastrophe that is this product. This is the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Pen. So you would think like it's like the secret brightening powder. You could put it under your eyes to really brighten the area. It's like a pen tip application. You twist it. I'm gonna... Okay, do you see what's happening here? It's balling up. It's not coming onto my hand. Seriously? So there it is. You could see it's very, very bally. What's the word? It's balling up everywhere. I'm gonna try to blend it and you could see. Imagine trying to put that on your face. Okay, tell me you guys, how would you put this under your eyes? It's a legit highlighter. It looks like a highlighter. Imagine putting that under your eyes. That's gonna show every single line and bump that you have because it's a highlighter. It doesn't have any coverage to it. And you know, you would think, okay, maybe it has a salmon undertone to really correct the under eyes. No, no. This looks like you put this Milk highlighter under your eyes. If I were to put this one here and this one here, they would look the same. This is literally the most confusing product I've ever come across. I guess if you really, really want to make it work, you can put it here, but please don't put it on your under eyes. Also, did I mention this thing is I'll list the price down below, but because I don't have it written down, but stay away. Again, if you're looking for a good highlighting concealer pen, go with the MAC Prep and Prime because this is shit. Okay, so the next product is by Ciate London, and this is their dual-ended eyeliner. This guy is $24. So one end is like a gajal, and the other end is a felt tip eyeliner. This pisses me off so much, you guys. Like, just look. I just bought this, and I've used it two times, and... look, it has completely dried out. Like, I'm really trying right there and it's just gone two times. That is unacceptable. And the second time was today. So I used it one other time and I attempted to use it today and it has completely died. The other thing is you cannot get a thin line with this thing. I attempted to get a thin line today, but it just got bigger and bigger and bigger until it was half the size of my eyeball. So if you're not good at eyeliner, like myself, stay far, far away from this. Also, I just got pissed off in the end and went over it with the Stila eyeliner because it just wasn't working. So you guys, please don't buy this. Even though it's not that expensive, please don't buy this unless you're only wanting this end, which is pretty nice. Okay, you guys, so that is the end of the shitty products video. I hope you guys really enjoyed it and took a couple of warnings from me. And if you guys like the video, don't forget to like and subscribe so that I could see all of you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.